Hello guys, and welcome back to another video from Vipin Sharma Biology Tutorials. In this video, we are going to talk about the next phylum of our discussion, that is Echinodermata. So like all the lectures, firstly we are going to talk about the peculiar feature or the characteristic feature of this phylum. Aisa kaun sa feature hai jo sirf isi phylum mein present hai? So as the name indicates, Echinodermata, it means spiny bodied. It means that there are different kind of spines which are present on their body. Alag tarike ke spines present rehte hain, is tarike ke structures. Okay? And they are commonly made up of calcium. That's why these are known as calcareous ossicles. Okay? Calcareous ossicles. Ossicles simply means tiny bone-like structures. For example, there are three ear ossicles in our ear that are malleus, incus and stapes. Stapes is the smallest bone of human. So, is tarike ki calcareous ossicles present hoti hai in the body of echinoderms. This is going to be the endoskeleton. Okay? Endoskeleton. So, in echinoderm, their name itself suggests that they are spiny bodied. It means that they will be containing spines which are formed up of calcareous ossicle and they will be forming the endoskeleton of body of an echinoderm. Okay, this is the first feature. But what is the most characteristic feature? Agar aapko confusion hai, to the second feature is water vascular system. We have already talked about water canal system in case of porifera. Here, water vascular system is present. So, canal, which is starting from C, comes initial. Right? So, it will be present in the porifera. V thoda baad mein aata hai, so it will be present in the last phylum, that is Echinodermata. So, water vascular system is present. Now, this water vascular system will be helping the echinoderm in locomotion, that is in the movement. After that, to capture the food and to transport the food. From one part of the body to the next part and respiration as well. Kyunki the food will also contain different kind of water, okay, and different kind of gases. So, with the water flow, the water, gases as well as food will come to the body of echinoderm. The echinoderm will be able to take food as well as the exchange of gases will take place. Or, the most important thing is that it also helps in the locomotion of an echinoderm. So, what are the two most important features? The first one is that they are spiny bodied. It means they are having different kind of calcareous or calcium containing ossicles which is forming their endoskeleton. After that, they are having water vascular system. Water vascular system ki aap kya kaam honge? The water, as the name indicates, water vascular system. So, the water will flow inside the body of echinoderms. The water will be taking different kind of nutrients with it and it will be taking different kind of gases with it. So, it will help in the gaseous exchange, that is respiration, as well as it is also very important to capture the food and to transport the food inside the body of echinoderm. These are the functions of water vascular system. Very, very important point from this particular phylum. Most important point. Right? After that, there are some points that we know very well, we just have to revise them. There is organ system level of organization. After platy helminthus, all of them are having organ system level. The porifera has cell aggregated plan. Coelenterata, Ctenophora having tissues. Platy helminthus are having organ level of organization. And after platy helminthus, all the animals are having organ system level organization. So this is clear. Then coelomate. Porifera, Coelenterata, Ctenophora, Platy helminthus are acoelomate, which are coming before Aeschylminthus. Aeschylminthus is pseudocoelomate, that is having the false coelom. And after Aeschylminthus, there are all the animals which contains true coelom, that are coelomates. Then, bilateral and radial symmetry both are present. Now, this is a special case. We are always talking that adult echinoderms, Coelenterata and Ctenophora are radially symmetrical and the rest of the animals are bilaterally symmetrical. Right? So the larva of echinoderms is bilaterally symmetrical and the adults of echinoderms are radially symmetrical. Now from platyhelminthus and all the other animals which are higher organization, they are having three germ layers: ectoderm, endoderm and mesoderm. So all of them are triploblastic. After that, the alimentary canal is complete. As they are having organ system level of organization, the alimentary canal is going to be complete. It means that there are going to be two separate openings. The first one is mouth and the second one is going to be anus. So the mouth and anus both are present. In this case, in the case of echinoderms, the mouth is present on the lower side. Okay, and it is ventral in position. Right, so ventral you can learn easily in most of the organisms, it is obviously ventral. But in this case, it is lower in position. So mouth kya hota hai? Position mein lower hota hai and it is ventral. But in case of anus, it is present at the upper side and it is dorsal. Right, so anus is present on the upper side and on the dorsal side, but mouth is present on the lower side and on the ventral side of the body of echinoderm. After that, the water vascular system is done. Excretory system is absent. Now I have marked E with a circle because E for echinoderms and E for excretory system. It means that echinoderm is quite developed phylum, but in spite of that, it is not having and well developed excretory system. So excretory system absent hai, isko aapko kaise yaad karna hai? Echinodermata ke starting ke letters jo hai, wo excretory system mein aate hai. So excretory system is absent in case of echinoderms. That is very important point. Ye aapko yaad karna hi padega. After that, sexes are separate. It means that there is male and there is female. It means that they are unisexual. After that, the sexes are separate, so they will be performing sexual reproduction. And in echinoderms, the fertilization is external. We have a trick for fertilization, that is CC hema eco, where eco simply means echinoderms. C means Coelenterata, Ctenophora, Hemichordata and Echinodermata, which are having external fertilization. So here it is showing external fertilization and the larva is going to be free swimming. It means that the development is indirect. Kyon? Kyunki larva present hai. If the larva is present, it simply means that the zygote is not getting directly developed into the adult organism. It is going through some stages, some phases. So larva is present and in most of the cases it is free swimming. So what are the most important points of echinoderms? The very first point and the most important point is they are exclusively marine. We have talked about the same point in case of Ctenophora, right? So Ctenophora and echinoderms, they are having some organisms which are exclusively marine. It means that they all are marine without any exception. So inke sare ke sare individuals jo hain, sare ke sare marine hote hain. After that, the larva is bilaterally symmetrical and the adults are radially symmetrical, which we have already discussed. The alimentary canal is complete. The mouth is present on the lower and ventral side. And the just opposite case in case of anus. The water vascular system is the peculiar feature. Excretory system is absent. Fertilization is external. And the development is indirect with a free swimming larva. These are the most important points from phylum Echinodermata. I hope that you got the lecture very well. Agar aap logon ko samajh mein aaya and pasand aaya, then do hit like button, share this video with your friends, subscribe to my channel and press the bell icon for sure. Thank you so much.